Do you waste a lot of material trying to get your projects to look just right? Then you need test grids. Test grids are a must-have for any laser enthusiast, whether you're doing projects on acrylic, leather, or even metal. It's good to have these to reference for any project. Test grids will not only allow you to choose the right tones for your projects, but also eliminate waste in doing trial runs. Go ahead and grab the test grid file in the link below and follow along in my process to make test grids for all your projects. Let's show you how to do some test grids on leather. Test chip open. I need to go in and type in the type of material that I'm gonna be burning on and then adjust the power settings for each of the grids. Now, a speedy way to do this is just select a row or a column and change that parameter across the board. That way you can do multitude of them and you don't have to do each one individually. I'm just going through and making sure that my speeds and my power settings for each of these little engraving blocks are matching what's written on the sides here. Now that I have all of this at the right setting, so that when I click 500 and 100, we have power 100 here and speed of 500 there. Or if I go to speed of 160, it matches on each setting. For the names, we're gonna do 80 and 2. Now for my material type, I'm gonna go ahead and delete that. We got light brown leather. Make sure it's fitting. Grave, power 80, 200, and then for cutting, 80 and 10. Now that we have this all set up on the laptop here, we can go ahead and frame. We can go ahead and process the artwork. We're gonna let it calculate down here. This should take about 1 minute, 30 seconds to do this. So we'll go ahead and hit start. Now that I have the test grid made, what this tells me or shows me is the different levels, like the depths of engraving and the different tones that I'm able to achieve at different powers and speeds for engraving. And this is great for when I want to do tones on magnets or for leather patches and I want to get two different shades. For this artwork that I did for the hat patches, I can use this chip to find the tones that I like. And so I like for my lighter tone, this one right here. So if I go over, that's speed of 400. And then if I go down, that's power of 60. And then for my darker tones, I like this chip here, which I see is speed of 100 and a power of 80. So then I can go to my artwork, select my lighter portions, power of 60, speed of 400, and then go in and select my darker areas, power of 80 and speed of 100. You can run similar test grids for cutting so that you can see different portions of your cuts or depths of your cuts. I just like running it for engraving so that I can see what engraving looks best. All right, now let's go ahead and run this. We have our dark spots that we had set using our test grid. And then we also have our light tones. Gives a nice contrast and more depth to our projects. So these test grids are a great way to minimize the waste in cutting projects. Before, I probably would have cut multiple projects, testing different settings to get exactly what I was looking for, where if I have a test grid, now I can always reference this and go back and be like, oh, I want this tone. And that way I don't have to burn a bunch of material. Whenever you have new material, make a test grid. Your future self is gonna be thanking you for saving you so much time and not having to mess around with different settings. If you enjoyed this video, be sure to like and subscribe, or if you know anybody that is wasting material, go ahead and share this video with them. And again, let me know in the comments what you want me to do next. I really love these projects, so yeah, I'm gonna get to making them. Thank you.